वेलकम टू फर्स्ट ईयर बीएससी सेकंड सेमेस्टर मैथमेटिक्स स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज केवीआर नरसिंहराव, लेक्चरर इन मैथमेटिक्स, श्री वेंकटेश्वर कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट्स एंड साइंस, अमलापुरम, ईस्ट गोदावरी डिस्ट्रिक्ट, एफिलिएटेड टू आदिकवि नन यूनिवर्सिटी, राजमंड्री. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव कंप्लीटेड the first semester of your first year. The examination will commence within a short period, that may be in July 2021. Due to the pandemic situation COVID-19, your examinations are continuously postponed from 27th May onwards. Anyhow, we hope that the situation will be normal. Then your examination will be commenced. According to the advice of the university, we will start the classwork for the second semester of yours through online. Because of the situation is not in control due to the pandemic situation, hence It is not a right time to conduct the examination, and the university will conduct the examination within a short period. So due to the minimization of the loss of academic period of yours, the university has advised to start the second semester classes. Hence we will start the second year, second semester classes of yours. In the first semester, your paper title is Differential Equations. So in the second semester, your mathematics paper title is Solid Geometry. So you know geometry from the early education, you know geometry. In intermediate, have known very well regarding two-dimensional geometry and a little bit of three-dimensional geometry also. In this semester, you have learned the three-dimensional geometry. What is meant by three-dimensional geometry? Three-dimensional geometry is otherwise called solid geometry. In two-dimensional geometry, you have only two axes, xo, x dash, and yo, y dash, and they intersect at O, dividing the whole plane into four parts. Each part is called a quadrant. Whereas in three-dimensional geometry, we have three lines, xo, x dash, yo, y dash, and zo, z dash intersect at O, then we get eight parts. Each part is called an octant. Each part is called an octant. The three lines intersect at O with mutually orthogonal. Hence, the three-dimensional system is otherwise called rectangular coordinate three-dimensional system. In this system, we have three axes, xox, that is x-axis, yoy, y-axis, and zoz dash, z-axis. Whereas in two-dimensional geometry, there are only two axes. In the three-dimensional geometry, we have three axes, x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. In two-dimensional geometry, we have only one plane, that is xo, xy dash, xo, x dash, y dash is the only xoy plane, that is xy plane. Whereas in three-dimensional geometry, we have three planes, xy plane, that is xoy, another is yoz, yz plane, and the last one is zox, zx plane. Whereas in the two dimensional geometry, we have only two plane, only one plane there. In this case, three dimensional geometry, we have three planes, xy plane, yz plane, and zx plane. So, the measurements are also have measured in the same manner as the two dimensional geometry. In two dimensional geometry, every point on the plane is of the form xy, small x comma small y, where small x is x coordinate and small y is y coordinate. Small x is the distance from origin to the point of intersection from the point on to the xy x axis, whereas small y is the distance from origin to the point of intersection from the point on to the y axis. That is the xy coordinate xy. In the first coordinate, that is plus x plus y. In the second coordinate, minus x plus y. In the third quadrant, it should be minus x minus y. In the fourth quadrant, plus x minus y. Now we will come to the three dimensional geometry. In any point on the x axis in two dimensional geometry is a comma 0. Any point on the y axis is 0 comma y. Now any point on the x axis in three dimensional geometry is a comma 0 comma 0 or x comma y comma z, whatever may be. Any point on y axis is 0 comma b comma 0. Any point on z axis is 0 comma 0 comma c. Any point in the space is x comma y comma z, where small x comma small y comma small z are distance from origin to the projection from the point onto yz plane, zx plane, and xy plane respectively. Whereas in two dimensional geometry, we have drawn perpendicular from the point onto the xy axis. Whereas in the three dimensional geometry, the perpendicular distances from can we calculate from origin to the points of intersection, that is projection point or foot of the perpendicular on yz plane, zx plane, and xy plane onto the from the point. Now any point on xy plane is a comma b comma 0. Any point on yz plane, 0 comma b comma 0. Any point on zx plane, 0 comma 0 comma c. So in three dimensional geometry, we have three planes, xy, yz, zx planes. These three planes are called coordinate planes. Three axes are called coordinate axes. Now, every point on the eight octants are, we have eight parts on dividing three lines intersected O. First octant, second octant, third octant, fourth octant, fifth octant, sixth octant, seventh octant, and eighth octant. Any point in the first octant is plus A comma B comma C. In the first octant, plus A plus B plus C. In the second octant, plus A plus B minus C. In the third octant, plus A minus B C. In the fourth octant, minus A plus B plus C. Fifth octant, plus X minus Y minus Z. In the sixth octant, minus X plus Y minus Z. In the seventh octant, minus X minus Y plus Z. In the eighth octant is minus X minus Y minus Z. This is the coordinate system, three dimensional geometry. Suppose if two points are chosen, say capital A x1 y1 z1 and capital B x2 y2 z2, then the distance between the two points is square root of
x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus z1 whole square. It is a similar to the distance between two points in two dimensional geometry. What is the distance between two points in two dimensional geometry? Square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Now in three dimensional geometry, the distance between the two points is square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus z1 whole square. This is the distance between. The distance between the point x, y, z from the origin, it is similar to this point. Instead of x2, y2, z2, we have 0, 0, 0. Hence, the distance between the two points x, y, z from the origin is square root of x minus 0 whole square plus y minus 0 whole square plus z minus 0 whole square is equal to square root of x square plus y square plus z square. This is the distance of the point from origin to the point. Now, distance of the point from xy plane to the origin is square root of a square plus b square, because on xy plane z is 0. Distance of the point from yz plane from the origin, from any point on yz plane to the origin, is square root of b square plus c square. Distance from origin to the any point on zx plane is square root of a square plus c square. Now we go to division of the point. Suppose two points are there, A x1, y1, z1, and B x2, y2, z2. C is another point, lies on the line at any point C, dividing the line AB in some ratio m is to n. Then the coordinates of the C are mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, comma my2 plus ny1 by m plus n plus mz2 plus nz1 by m plus n. This is the coordinates of any point on the line joining ax1, y1, z1 and bx2, y2, z2 in the ratio m is to n. If the ratio is not m is to n, if the ratio is some m, lambda is to 1, then the coordinates of the point C is lambda x2 plus x1 by lambda plus 1, lambda y2 plus y1 by lambda plus 1, lambda z2 plus z1 by lambda plus 1. If lambda is positive, then the point C lies in between A and B. If lambda is negative, that is less than 0, then the point C lies outside the points AB, that is external division of the point AB. If the C lambda is positive, then the point C, which divides internally. If lambda is negative, the point divides AB externally. If lambda is equal to 1, then the point C lies in between A and B. That is midpoint of AB is lambda, that is x1 plus x2 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2, z1 plus z2 by 2. If lambda is equal to 2 is to 1 or 1 is to 2, then the point C is called point of trisection. Point of trisection. If lambda is equal to minus 1 is to 2 or minus 2 is to 1, then the point lies outside A and B, then the division is called point of trisection externally. Now, a point divides the xy plane of the line joining AX1, Y1, Z1 and BX2, Y2, Z2. That means, if the line joining AX1, Y1, Z1 and BX2, Y2, Z2 divides the, that means passing through the plane, that is XY plane. Any point on XY plane is z coordinate 0. That is, the ratio is minus z1 is to z2. Any the line joining two points which divide the xy plane is minus z1 is to z2. Similarly, the ratio in which the plane divide the line joining the plane yz plane divide the line joining ax1 y1 z1 and bx2 y2 z2 is minus x1 is to x2. Similarly, the ratio in which the zx plane divide the line joining ax1 y1 z1 and bx2 y2 z2 is minus y1 is to y2. Now, centroid of the triangle. How many points required for drawing a triangle? 3 points are required. The 3 points may be ax1 y1 z1 and bx2 y2 z2 and cx3 y3 z3. What is a centroid? Centroid is a point which lies on the median line in the ratio of joining the vertex to the midpoint of its opposite side in the ratio 2 is to 1 or 1 is to 2 is called centroid. Centroid is the point lies on the median line. What is meant by median line? Median line is a line drawn from vertex to the midpoint of its opposite side. So centroid lies on that line which divides the median line in 2 is to 1 or 1 is to 2. Hence the centroid is the concurrence point of the three median lines. Because we can draw three median lines for a triangle, therefore the three points are concurrent. That concurrent point is called centroid. The centroid of the triangle ABC, AX1, Y1, Z1, BX2, Y2, Z2 and CX3, Y3, Z3 is G is equal to X1 plus X2 plus X3 by 3, Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3 by 3, Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 by 3. So this formula is used to determine centroid of the triangle. The problems can be practiced after the completion of the all these basics, because all these basics have already learned in intermediate. Even though I will reminding the formulas and subject what you have learned earlier on the geometry are to be explained now. Now, what is the tetrahedron? What is the difference between triangle and a tetrahedron? Triangle is the physical shape obtained by connecting the three points 2 by 2 will give the triangle. In a triangle, we have three sides and three angles. The three sides are not same, then the triangle is called scalar triangle. If the three sides are equal, then the triangle is called equilateral triangle. Two sides are equal, then it is called isosceles triangle. If one of the angle is 90 degrees, then it is a right angle triangle. One angle is right angle and two sides are equal, then it is called a right angle isosceles triangle. If all the three sides are different, then it is called scalar triangle. In a right angle triangle, one side which is a longer side, that is called hypotenuse. According to the Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides. That is, hypotenuse square is equal to side 1 whole square plus side 2 whole square. This is the formula for hypotenuse according to the Pythagoras theorem. Now, our subject is related to what is meant by tetrahedron. What is meant by tetrahedron? Tetrahedron is the physical shape obtained by drawing from an external point to the three sides of a triangle is called tetrahedron. Suppose if ABC be a triangle, capital D be a point outside the triangle, not inside the triangle. If you have to connect D2A, D2B, D2C. We get a physical shape, that what is called tetrahedron. So tetrahedron requires four vertices, A x1, y1, z1, and B x2, y2, z2, and C x3, y3, z3. And D x4, y4, z4. Now, similar to the triangle, we have centroid. Tetrahedron also have centroid. The centroid of the tetrahedron lies on the line joining vertex the opposite face, because tetrahedron has four faces, that's why it is called tetrahedron. So four faces, if you have to draw a line from one vertex, say D, onto its opposite face ABC, that is called median line. So centroid is a point which lies on this line in the ratio 3:1 or 1:3. That is called centroid. And the centroid of the triangle is ABC is x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3 plus y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3 z1 plus z2 plus z3 by 3 is say G is the centroid of the triangle ABC. Now what is the fourth vertex? X4, Y4, Z4, that is G. Draw a line from D to G, then end a point which divides on D and G in the ratio 3:1 is X1 plus X2 plus X3 plus X4 by 4 plus Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3 plus Y4 by 4 Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 plus Z4 by 4. This is the centroid of the triangle. Suppose the one vertex is origin, then the centroid of the triangle is x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3. D is origin. Y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 4. Z1 plus z3, z2 plus z3 by 4. This is the centroid of the triangle. Based upon the above formula, now we will practice certain problems to know the knowledge which is very much required in our future subject correspondence. So that's why, first of all, find the distance between the points capital A 2, 4, 3 and B 5, minus 1, minus 7. Now we want to find the distance between the two points. What are the two points? A 2, 4, 3 and B 5, minus 1, minus 7. What is the formula for distance between two points? AB is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus z1 whole square. This implies square root of 5 minus 2 whole square plus minus 1 minus 1 whole square plus minus 7 minus 3 whole square. Because the first point is 2, 1, 3, not 2, 4, 3. Therefore, on simplification, the distance between the two points AB is square root 43 units. This is the distance between the two points. Now we want next problem. Find the distance of P 5, 1, 6 from the origin. That means the first point is 5, 1, 3, 5, 1, 6. Second point is 0, 0, 0. The same formula. Distance of the point P from the origin is square root of x square plus y square plus z square. Because other point is 0, 0, 0. Gives the square root of 5 square plus 1 square plus 6 square. Is equal to square root 62 units. Now, find the length of AB, BC, AC. When A is equal to minus 2, minus 1, minus 3. B is equal to 6, 6, 6. C is equal to 2, 3, minus 5. So using these 3 points, what are the 3 points? A minus 2, minus 1, minus 3, B 6, 6, 6, C 2, 3, minus 5. Distance AB is equal to square root of 6 plus 2 whole square plus 6 plus 1 whole square plus 6 plus 3 whole square is equal to square root 194. Distance between BC points, that is square root of 2 minus 6 whole square plus 3 minus 6 whole square plus minus 5 minus 6 whole square is equal to square root 196. Distance between the 2 points A and C is square root of 2 plus 2 whole square plus 3 plus 1 whole square plus minus 5 plus 3 whole square is equal to root 36 is equal to 6 units. So these are the problems based upon square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus z1 whole square. Now we go to division ratio in which the point divides the line joining 2 points in the ratio m is to n or lambda is to 1. For convenience, for solving the problems problematically, you may use lambda is to 1 is much easier than using m is to n. So you should prefer lambda is to 1. Find the point which divides the line joining the points capital A minus 6, 5, 11 and B minus 3, minus 5, 10 in the ratio 3 is to 2. Now we want to find the point which divides the line joining A x1, y1, z1 and B x2, y2, z2 in the ratio m is to n, whatever may be. That is, m is equal to 3, n is equal to 2. What is the point which divides the line joining AB in the ratio m is to n? Mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n. My2 plus ny1 by m plus n. Mz2 plus nz1 by m plus n. What is x1, y1, z1? X1, y1, z1 is minus 6, 5, 11. X2, y2, z2, minus 3, minus 5, 10. On substituting these values, we get the point C is minus 21 by 5, minus 1, plus 52 by 5. This is the point which divides the line joining A and B in the ratio 3 is to 2. Find the midpoint of the line joining. Now another problem. Find the midpoint of the line joining P 1 1 1 and Q 3 3 3. What is the formula for midpoint? X1 plus X2 by 2, Y1 plus Y2 by 2, Z1 plus Z2 by 2. What is X1, Y1, Z1? 1 1 1. What is X2, Y2, Z2? 3 3 3. Therefore, the midpoint is 1 plus 3 by 2, 1 plus 3 by 2, 1 plus 3 by 2 is equal to 4 by 2, 4 by 2, 4 by 2 is equal to 2, 2, 2, the midpoint. Next one is find the length of the median from A 1, 2, minus 1 on the line BC of the triangle ABC when B 3, 4, 2 and C 5, 1, 6. What are the given points? A 1, 2, minus 1, B 3, 4, 2, C 5, 1, 6. Midpoint of BC, because we want to find the median. What is meant by median line? Median line is a line joined from vertex to the midpoint of its opposite side. So in the problem, the examiner will ask the point vertex is A 1, 2, minus 1. So opposite side is BC. That's why midpoint of BC is 3 plus 5 by 2, 4 plus 1 by 2, 6 plus 2 by 2 is equal to 4, comma 5 by 2, comma 4. Now median from A to BC is AD is equal to square root of 4 minus 1 whole square plus 5 by 2 minus 1 whole, 5 by 2 minus 1 whole square plus 4 plus 1 whole square is equal to square root of 9 plus 1 by 4 plus 25. This on simplification, it will give root 187 by 4. Now another problem. Find the centroid of a triangle formed by minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 2, 1, 5 and 6, 2, 3. Now we want to find the centroid of the triangle ABC. The three points are given. Consider the three points are A, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, B, 2, 1, 5, C, 6, 2, 3. What is the formula for centroid of the triangle? X1 plus X2 plus X3 by 3, Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3 by 3, Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 by 3. Therefore, this on simplification, centroid of the triangle ABC is 6 plus 2 minus 1 by 3, 2 plus 1 minus 2 by 3, 3 plus 5 minus 3 by 2, 3 is equal to 7 by 3, 1 by 3 and 5 by 3. Another problem. If the centroid of the triangle is origin. Center of the triangle is origin. When the two vertices are 5 minus 5, 6, 6, 5, 2. Find the third vertex. It is also a similar problem to find the centroid of the triangle. Whereas in the previous problem, we have computed centroid by using the three given points. In this problem, centroid is given, that is G is given, one vertex is not given. That vertex is to be determined. So, centroid G is equal to 0, 0, 0. A is equal to 5 minus 5, 6. B is equal to 6, 5, 2. Let the third vertex be X, Y, Z. Then from substituting in the formula, that is centroid 0, 0, 0 is equal to X1 plus X2 plus X3 by 3, Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3 by 3, Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 by 3. This on simplification, one minute. Therefore, 0, 0, 0 is equal to 5 plus 6 plus X by 3, comma, minus 5 plus 5 plus Y by 3, comma, 6 plus 2 plus Z by 3. Maybe X1, X3, Y3, Z3 also substituting. In the material, we have the third vertex is chosen as X3, Y3, Z3. It may be X, Y, Z also. So, this implies 0, 0, 0 is equal to 11 plus X3 by 3, comma, Y3 by 3, comma, 8 plus Z3 by 3. So, equating the similar coordinates, we get 11 plus X3 by 3 is equal to 0, implies X3 is equal to minus 7. Y3 by 3 is equal to 0, implies Y3 equal to 0. 8 plus Z3 by 3 is equal to 0, implies Z3 equal to minus 8. Therefore, the third vertex C, X3, Y3, Z3 is equal to minus 11 0 minus a. Now we go to next problem. Find the centroid of the tetrahedron formed by 1 1 1 2 3 2 5 1 6 6 4 3. So centroid has 4 vertices. What is the formula for centroid of the triangle, centroid of the tetrahedron? X1 plus X2 plus X3 plus X4 by 4, Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3 plus Y4 by 4, Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 plus Z4 by 4. So X1, Y1, Z1, X2, Y2, Z2, X3, Y3, Z3, X4, Y4, Z4 have all given. What is A? 1, 1, 1. What is B? 2, 3, 2. What is C? 5, 1, 6. What is D? 6, 4, 3. So, centroid of the triangle is 1 plus 2 plus 5 plus 6 by 4, comma, 1 plus 3 plus 1 plus 4 by 4, comma, 7 plus 2 plus 6 plus 3 by 4 implies centroid of the triangle is 7 by 2, 9 by 4, 3. This is the centroid of the triangle. Next, 10th problem. If the centroid of the tetrahedron is minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, whose other vertices, 3 vertices of the are 5, 1, 6, 2, 3, 2, minus 2, minus 2, minus 3. Find the fourth vertex. In the previous, in the problem just previous to the last problem, we have find this fourth, third vertex in center of the triangle. Similarly, in this case, fourth vertex by using the centroid and other 3 points. G is equal to minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. A is equal to, let A is equal to XYZ, B is equal to 516, C is equal to 232, D is equal to minus 2, minus 2, minus 3. So therefore, centroid G is equal to X1 plus X2 plus X3 plus X4 by 4, Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3 plus Y4 by 4, Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 plus Z4 by 4. What is the centroid given as? Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Is equal to X plus 5 plus 2 minus 2 by 4, comma, X plus 1 plus 3 minus 2 by 4, comma, Z minus 6 plus 2 minus 3 by 4. Equating the similar coefficient, similar coordinates will give X is equal to minus 9, Y is equal to 6, minus 6, Z is equal to minus 9. Therefore, the fourth vertex, that is ABC, that is AXYZ, sorry, not ABC, AXYZ is equal to minus 9, minus 6, minus 4. Now, another problem. Find the ratio in which the YZ plane divides the line joining the points A, minus 5, minus 7, minus 11, and B, minus 3, minus 5, minus 5. In this case, if a line joining A, X1, Y1, Z1, B, X2, Y2, Z2, passing through a plane, that is XY plane, so not Y, not X, YZ plane. What is the formula for YZ plane? Divide the line joining AX1, Y1, Z1, BX2, Y2, Z2, minus X1 is to X2. Therefore, the ratio is 5 is to minus 3 or minus 5 is to 3, direct formula. Or you may get the same value by choosing lambda is to 1, find lambda also. Easiest formula is YZ plane divided the line joining AX1, Y1, Z1 and BX2, Y2, Z is minus X1 is to X2. Now, find the locus of the point. So this problem can be done in the next class. Hence, my dear students, I have completed the basic concepts
of some up to some extent for the three dimensional geometry in our future sub discussions have been discussed with practically as well as theoretically. Hence, I think there is no doubt of understanding through learning of this audio video lesson from our YouTube channel. Hence, I am suggesting to you to listen these lessons with a number of times and try to prepare notes by your own from this material, and you can also write the complete notes by pausing the video, audio and seeing the notes very perfectly from this lesson. I think these basics are very much required, very much necessary in our future subject discussions. Hence, my dear students, I have completed lesson number 1 of unit 1 in your second semester mathematics paper solid geometry. So listen very carefully and try to listen complete lesson, not by 5 or 10 minutes. We are not expecting views from you. I am expecting to learn some knowledge from this audio video lessons, because due to the pandemic situation, to the COVID-19, we are unable to learn the subject directly. Hence, the COVID-19 give a chance to us for learning the lessons, not only by direct, but also we can learn the lessons through online also. Hence, my dear students, take it as a chance and try to learn very perfectly and promptly. Thank you very much. We will meet in the next lesson. God bless you.